وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وإمامنا وقدوتنا وشفيعنا ونورنا وخطيبنا يوم القيامة المبعوث رحمة العالمين حبيب القلوب طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها وقوت الأرواح وغذائها ذو الوجه الأنور والجبين الأزهر والقبر الأعطر رحمة الله ومنة الله ونعمة الله وصفوة الله وعطاء الله وهدى الله سبحانه وتعالى محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم محبوب رب العالمين ومحبوب السماوات والأرض والأشجار والأحجار والبحار والثمار صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
So he began in the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate, and sending prayers and peace upon the beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who mentioned in the most beautiful ways with the most beautiful characteristics that are summarized in his being sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who is beloved to Allah, beloved to all those here in the earth sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
نحن وإياكم في هذه الساعة نتكلم عن أشرف علم أنزله الله عز وجل في الأرض.
We are going to be speaking together now about the greatest of all knowledge that descended from heaven to earth.
وأهل هذا العلم هم صفوة الله وخاصته.
And the people of this knowledge are the choice people of Allah Ta'ala's creation.
هم الفائزون بسعادة الدنيا والآخرة.
They are the ones that are truly successful and felicitous in this world and the next.
نحن وإياكم نقرأ لمحة من علومهم.
That we're going to read together, you and I, that just a small amount of their knowledge.
ورشفة من رشفاتهم.
And just literally a sip from the outpour of their cup.
وقبسا من نورهم.
And just one little bit, a ray of their light.
وجملة من خطابهم.
And that just only one sentence out of their vast discourse.
هذا الذي سنتكلم عنه يحتاج إلى أوعية القلوب أن تكون حاضرة وصافية.
What we're going to be speaking about requires is that the hearts be prepared, pure and ready.
هذا العلم ظلم أهله.
Is that this knowledge, its people have been oppressed.
وأسيء فهمه.
And people have had a misunderstanding of them.
وصار الناس يرونه تهمة.
And people see it as something that people that are suspicious of.
لجهلهم بهذا المقام.
Because of their ignorance of what it truly is.
والإنسان عدو ما يجهل.
And that in general, that people are an enemy to that which they do not know.
علم السلوك أو علم التصوف أو علم الأخلاق أو علم السير أو علم الذوق أو علم الحال أو علم السر هذا كله سنتكلم عنه في هذا الكتاب.
So the knowledge of that the heart, the knowledge of purification, the knowledge of traveling the spiritual path, the knowledge of experience, the knowledge of secrets, that this is what we're going to be speaking about.
كثيرون كتبوا عنه.
That many people have written about it.
كثيرون توسعوا في خطاب في وصفه.
That there are many people that have that depicted it.
وكل أهل زمن لهم علماؤه يشرحون لهم معنى هذا العلم.
And then in every time there are scholars that explain to the people of that time the nature of this knowledge.
ونحن نعيش في عصر التكنولوجيا وعصر الانفتاح على العالم. فيحتاج إلى من يشرح لنا مصطلحات هذا العلم بأسلوب يفهمه الجميع.
So that we live in a time and a time that is that characterized by a globalized world, and it requires is that there be scholars of this time that explain this knowledge to us.
سيدي الحبيب عمر نفعنا الله به.
And that our teacher سيدي الحبيب عمر
قد وضع يعني بعض السمات والصفات أو لأهم الصفات لهذا العلم وأهله.
So in this work is that he laid down for us some of the most important traits of the people of this knowledge.
وهذه الصفات هي ركن الدين.
is that these traits are the foundation of the deen.
والدين كما تعلمون ينقسم إلى ثلاث أقسام نتكلم عنها إن شاء الله تعالى بعد أن يعرض عليكم ترجمة الفصل الأول.
So that the deen has three pillars, as you all know, that we're going to speak about them after that we read the translation of the first chapter. So I think what we're going to do is, I think this is a bit distracting here. If you could just turn the projector off. And what I'll do is, what's that?
The shadow.
Yeah, just turn the projector off and turn the lights on, and I'll just read it from here, inshallah, so everyone can just pay attention, and Habib is going to comment on it, inshallah. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, all praise belongs to Allah. He is Allah in the heavens and on earth. He knows your secrets and what you reveal, and He knows what you do. Remember that God knows what is in your soul, so be mindful of Him. And I bear witness that there is no God except Allah, one without partner. There is no secret conversation between three people where He is not the fourth, nor between five where He is not the sixth, nor between less or more than that without Him being with them, wherever they may be. On the day of resurrection, He will show them what they have done. Allah truly has full knowledge of everything. And I bear witness that our Master Prophet, in the coolness of our eyes, Muhammad is His servant and messenger. He sent with Him guidance in the religion of truth, to show that it is above all other religions, however much the polytheists may hate this. The Exalted addressed Him with His saying, O Prophet, we have sent you as a witness, as a bearer of good news and warning, as one who calls people to Allah by His leave, and as a light-giving lamp. Give the believers the good news that the great bounty awaits them from Allah. And by His words, Exalted is He, Noon, by the pen, by all they write, your Lord's grace does not make you, Prophet, a madman. You will have a never-ending reward. Truly, you have a strong character. The Exalted also described Him as such. Allah has been truly gracious to the believers in sending them a messenger from among their own to recite His revelation to them, to make them grow in purity and to teach them the scripture and wisdom. Before that, they were clearly astray. And by His words, a messenger has come to you from among yourselves. Your suffering distresses Him. He is deeply concerned for you and full of kindness and mercy towards the believers. O Allah, send your most graceful prayers and peace, and purest peace upon your servant and beloved, our Master Muhammad, the guide to the straight path, and upon his folk and the people of the house, the Ahl Bayt, those coupled with the Quran who will not separate until they come to him at his Hawd, at his basin, on the day of resurrection, upon his companions, the Muhajirin and the Ansar, the people of precedence, grace and honor, and upon those who follow them with excellence, and upon his fathers and brothers from the prophets and messengers, their families and companions, the angels brought near, and all of the Allah's righteous servants to proceed. This is a brief clarification that suffices and brings healing regarding the realities of Sufism and the traits of the people of the spiritual path. By Allah's will, it will benefit those from among Allah's servants who are justly seeking clarification and guidance. May Allah expand the benefit of the author, reader, scribe, listener, and the entire ummah of the Prophet Muhammad. So this is Habib Umar's introduction to this book and to this treatise.
ذكر في أول المقدمة مقتطفات من آيات الله عز وجل في القرآن الكريم.
So he mentioned in the first part of this book that verses from the Quran al-Kareem.
خلاصتها تتحدث عن أمرين مهمين جداً.
So we could summarize these verses and say that they are really speaking to about two different affairs.
العبد في الدنيا لابد أن يعلم أن الله يعلم سره وجهره وهو معه.
Is that the servant in this world must know that Allah knows the reality of his inward state and his outward state and everything that he does.
فلو علم هذا العلم كفاه.
Were the servant to only know this knowledge, it would suffice him.
كفاه من حيث أنه لا يمكن أن يعصي أو أن يفكر أن يعصي.
It would suffice him from the standpoint is that he would be unable to think about sin or actually commit a sin.
لا يأتيه الخوف لأن الله معه.
That he wouldn't that have fear of falling into that sin because he realizes that Allah is with him.
إنما يخاف من شيء واحد.
He would only really fear one thing.
أن يتركه الله.
Is that Allah would leave him.
أو أن يبعده الله.
Or that Allah would make him distant.
وهذا يسمونه أهل العلم هو عذاب الجحيم.
And this is what the people of this knowledge term the true punishment of the fire.
ولذلك أناس يوم القيامة عذابهم ماذا؟ لا يكلمهم الله ولا ينظر إليهم ولا يزكيهم.
And this is why there will be peoples whose punishment on the day of judgment is that Allah Ta'ala does not speak to them, He does not gaze upon them.
بالمقابل من أعظم نعيم الآخرة أقوام يكلمهم الله وينظر إليهم ويزكيهم الله يجعلنا من خالصين.
And that there is another group of people who are their opposite, and that these are people who Allah Ta'ala will address. These will be people that Allah Ta'ala gazes upon.
في أحد الأيام كنت في دار المصطفى.
Is it one day when I was in Dar al-Mustafa?
صلينا الفجر خلف الحبيب عمر.
That we prayed Salat al-Fajr behind Habib Umar.
وجلسنا إلى الإشراق.
And we remained with him until sunrise.
صلينا الضحى.
And we prayed Salat al-Duhى.
فخرجت مع الحبيب عمر.
And that I walked out with Habib Umar.
فسألته.
And I asked him.
كنا نقرأ معه تحزيب القرآن بعد الفجر.
Is that we were reciting the Quran after Fajr, and I asked him.
قلت له يا حبيب الله يقول ليسأل الصادقين عن صدقهم فقلت له حتى الصادقون يسألون يوم القيامة.
And that he said about the verse is that in order that the truthful will be asked about their truthfulness, and that he says is that even the people that are described as being truthful will be asked on the day of judgment.
نحن نعلم أن الناس يسألون يوم القيامة عن ذنوبهم عن سيئاتهم عن معاصيهم. لكن يسأل الإنسان عن صدقه.
Is that it's we know that we'll be asked about the sins that we commit, the mistakes that we've made, and so forth. But a person will be asked about that their good traits like truthfulness.
فتبسم إلي سيدي الحبيب عمر.
And so then Habib Umar smiled.
وقال لي سؤال محبة.
He said the asking of love.
سؤال منا. سؤال منا نعمة.
And so that Allah Ta'ala is asking it out of love, asking it to show His blessing.
يعني كأن الله يقول لما كنت صادقا فيقول العبد لك يا ربي من أعطاك الصدق أنت يا ربي.
And so it's as if Allah Ta'ala is saying that why were you that truthful, O servant of mine? And so that then the servant can respond.
لذلك أنتم اليوم كنتم تذكرون بعد صلاة الفجر اللهم أنت خلقتني وأنت تهديني وأنت تطعمني وأنت تسقيني. أنت هو يخاطب به الحاضر في اللغة العربية. لكن نحن الآن لا نشاهده بأعيننا ولكن تخاطب خطاب حاضر. اللهم أنت خلقتني وأنت تهديني وأنت تطعمني وأنت تسقيني وأنت تميتني وأنت تحييني.
So this morning after Salat al-Fajr, when we were reciting the word of Latif, is that we were addressing our Lord, and we were saying, is that you are the one who created us, you are the one who guided us, you are the one who gave us life, and you are the one that causes us to die. You are the one who feeds us, you are the one who gives us drink. We are speaking to Allah in the second person, saying you.
أتعلمون لماذا؟
Do you know why we do this?
لأنه يوم القيامة سيسألك ربك من الذي خلق فتقول أنت خلقتني من الذي هداك أنت الذي هديتني من الذي أطعمك أنت تطعمني فتقول له يوم القيامة مجاهرة.
This is because on the day of judgment Allah will address us and say, who is the one who created you? We will then say, you were the one who created us. Who is the one who guided you? And we will then say, you are the one who guided us. And He will go through those questions on the Day of Judgment, and that we will respond.
هذا الذي سنتكلم عنه. كيف نصل إلى هذا الخطاب الذي قال عنه النبي أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه.
This is what we will be speaking about, is that how can we make a reality in us that what our Prophet said is that in order for us to, how can we worship Allah that as if we see Him?
No. Bismillah. فصل اللي بعده
حكى التصوف. So this is the chapter, it's titled Sufism. Sufism is acting with excellence, ihsan, and taking on the qualities pursuant with the divine address and his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, experientially and with realization. Therefore, it is ascending from the knowledge of certainty, ilm al-yaqeen, to the eye of certainty, ayn al-yaqeen, and its reality, haqq al-yaqeen. Sufism is traveling and climbing the ladder of Islam and Iman until attaining the ranks of nearness to Allah and ilaknosis, and complete love from Allah and for Allah. And it is excellence in following our Master, the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and attaining the fruits of that in the love of Allah, the glorious and majestic.
التصوف هل هو كلام هل هو فلسفة هل هو خطاب هو ليس فلسفة وليس كلاما وليس جدالا إنما هو علم علم تصفية القلب عما سوى الله تبارك وتعالى الذي قال الله عنه إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم.
So he's posing the question, what is tasawwuf? Is it merely words? Is it some type of address? Is it philosophy? Is it some type of way of debate? He says, Tasawwuf is not philosophy, it is not merely words, it is not meant to be a source of debate. He said, the essence of Tasawwuf is purifying the heart from everything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Tasawwuf huwa ilmun laysa fil kutub.
Tasawwuf is a knowledge that is not in books.
Innama huwa ilmun fil sudur.
It is a knowledge that is in the heart.
التصوف هو علم علم عمل.
It is a knowledge that requires practice.
وليس علم جدل.
And not a knowledge that we just argue about and talk about.
التصوف هو الجهاد الأكبر.
The tasawwuf is the greatest form of jihad.
أنك تجاهد أعداء أعدائك هي نفسك.
Because you fight against the greatest of your enemies, which is your own self.
نفسك هذه التي تعيش منذ أن ولدت إلى أن تموت.
Your own soul that has been living from the time that you were born and will remain with you until you die.
فلذلك الله جعل الله الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم من أنفسنا.
And this is why that Allah Ta'ala made the beloved Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم from our own selves.
فاجعل هواك تبعا لما جاء به.
So we should make our desire, our caprice, that in following in accordance with what he brought.
يقول الحبيب هنا في كتابه رضي الله عنه هو حسن العمل لا العمل لا المطلوب أن تعمل أن مطلوب أن تعمل بأحسن الأعمال أن تقول أحسن الأقوال أن تتصف بأحسن الأخلاق.
And so that Habib Umar said here, Sufism is acting with excellence. Notice here he didn't say just acting. It's acting with its husn al-amal, with excellence, is that we do the very best of all things. We say the very best of all words. We have the very best of all types of character.
لذلك يقول هنا أن تعمل بمقتضى التنزيل أي أن تمشي بالعمل بمقتضى الكتاب والسنة.
And so he says that here, that on the qualities pursuant with the divine address that come in the Quran, that come through our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
ذوقاً وتحققاً,
is that experientially that there's ذوق and with realization تحقق.
الذوق هو بما يسمى حق اليقين.
Is that ذوق, taste, experience, is what we call حق اليقين, that is the reality of certainty.
مثال ذلك لو شخص لا لم يطعم الْعَسَلَ مِنْ قَبْلُ.
And so an example of this were someone to have never tasted honey before.
فَقَالَ لِلْآخَرْ صِفْ لِي طَعْمَ الْعَسَلِ.
And one said to someone else, describe to me the taste of honey.
فَشَرَحَ لَهُ الْعَسَلُ طَعْمُهُ كَذَا وَكَذَا وَكَذَا وَكَذَا.
And he tried to explain how honey tasted.
هَلْ سَيَصِلْ إِلَى طَعْمِ الْحَقِيقِي.
Is it, would we get to the true taste of honey through that?
لا. هذا يسمونه علم اليقين.
This is what we call the knowledge of certainty.
علم اليقين أعرف أن هذا الأمامي عسل.
Is it, the knowledge of certainty is that you know this substance before me is honey.
وأعلم أن طعمه طيب.
And I know that it has a good taste.
فإذا رأيته صار عين اليقين.
Is that if I actually see that honey, is that it becomes now the eye of certainty.
فإذا طعمته صار حق اليقين.
And that when I actually taste it, that is an example of how we understand the reality of certainty.
لذلك نحن نعلم أن الصلاة واجبة. هذا علم اليقين.
So that we know through the knowledge of certainty that prayer is an obligation.
فإذا دخلنا في الصلاة صار عين اليقين.
Is that when we actually enter into prayer, it's like the eye of certainty.
فإذا نسينا ما سوى الله هذا عين اليقين.
Is that if we forget everything other than Allah, that's like the truth of certainty.
لذلك الصوفي يرى إذا خطر على قلبي في الصلاة غير الله يعتبر نفسه أنه لم يصلي.
So this is why the true Sufi, if he has a thought come to his heart other than Allah, is that he considers it as if he hasn't really prayed.
Allah, انظروا نحن الآن كم عمرنا في الإسلام.
So he says, look at our own selves, how long have we been Muslim?
منا من كان ولد مسلما وبلغ الثلاثين الأربعين الخمسين لم يذق تسبيحة في صلاته هو يصلي ويسبح لكن لم يصل إلى عين اليقين.
There are some of us who have been Muslim, have been born Muslim, have lived 40, 50 years, and we haven't tasted the sweetness of one tasbihah, that is saying subhanAllah in our prayers. Were we to taste that, what it means to say subhanAllah, that would be like the eye of certainty.
وَلَوْ ذَاقَ تَسْبِيحَةً وَاحِدَةً لَمَا صَبَرَ عَلَى أَنْ يَذْكُرَ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى طُولَ عُمْرِهِ.
Is it, were we to taste the sweetness of saying one tasbihah, that is saying subhanAllah, is that we would not be patient to not be in a state of dhikr for the remaining part of our life.
لذلك تكثر من تسبيح سبحان الله إذا لم تقبل الأولى الثانية سبحان الله إذا لم تقبل الثانية الثالثة سبحان الله سبحان الله فكثرة التسبيح بمثابة قرع الباب الأولى الثانية لعل الله يفتح لك بعد المئة بعد المئتين بعد الألف.
So this is why we say subhanAllah after subhanAllah we say subhanAllah then we say subhanAllah again. And it is like knocking on the door, the hopes of which is that one time when we will say subhanAllah, that the door will open and we'll taste the sweetness that of saying subhanAllah.
هناك في تريم سيدنا الحبيب عمر المحضار من سيد عبد الرحمن السقاف.
Is it in Tareem there are two of the great saints by the name of Sheikh Abd al-Rahman al-Saqaf and Sayyidina Umar Mihdar, his son.
من كبار أهل تريم.
They are from the great the people of Tareem.
قال لو علمت أن الله قبل مني تسبيحة واحدة لأطعمت أهل تريم ثلاثة أيام بالبر واللحم.
So Sayyidina Umar Mihdar said, were I to know that Allah accepted from me one tasbihah, just saying subhanAllah, that I would invite all of the people of Tareem over and I would feed them for 3 days straight with the best of food for them, which was meat and wheat.
قال هذا باب التواضع.
And some might say that, okay, this might be out of humility.
لذلك هذا العلم يساعد العبد إلى أن يصل إلى أن يتصل العبد بالمعبود في قالب الصلاة أو الذكر أو القرآن أو مجلس العلم.
And this is why this knowledge facilitates for the human being the true way to be with Allah when they're remembering Allah in gatherings of knowledge and gatherings of remembrance when they're reading Quran.
لذلك سحرة فرعون ذكرنا ذلك خرجوا يتحدون سيدنا موسى.
And so we see, for instance, the Pharaoh's magicians is that they went out to challenge that the Prophet Moses.
ولكن لما ذهبوا أغراهم فرعون بأنه سيجعلهم من المقربين.
Is that when they went out? Is that Fir'aun said to them, is that if they are victorious, is that they will be from those the closest people to him, his inner circle.
فاجتمعوا سحرة فرعون 70,000 ساحر وسيدنا موسى ومعه أخوه هارون فقط.
And so 70,000 of these magicians gathered, and it was on the other side only the Prophet Moses and his brother Aaron.
سيدنا موسى قال كلمة واحدة هي التي دخلت قلوب السحرة فغيرتهم وخوفتهم.
Sayyidina Musa only said one word, and that went into directly into the hearts of the Pharaoh's magicians, and that brought about fear.
قال موسى ويلكم لا تفتروا على الله كذبا فيسحتكم بعذاب وقد خاب من افترى.
And he says that woe to you, is that were you to that say then a word and then that receive the wrath of Allah.
هنا خافوا لأن الساحر يعرف أن عصاته هي تخيلات وليست ثعابين حقيقية.
Is that they feared because is that the magicians knew is that their staffs were not that really that snakes, is that it was just an optical illusion.
فلما رمى سيدنا موسى عصاته تحولت إلى ثعبان حقيقي وهم حبالهم عصيهم ثعابين خيالية ليس حقيقية فأكل ثعبان هوثا حبالهم عصيهم فخر السحرة سجدا لأنهم صدقوا في تلك السجدة فكشف الله لهم منازلهم في الجنة.
And so is that whereas Moses when he threw his staff it turned into a real snake that ate their ropes that were that an optical illusion as if they were snakes. And when they saw this that they realized is that this was a person of truth and they immediately went into prostration. And as a result of their sincerity and prostration, Allah unveiled for them their places in paradise.
That we
have the words then of Sayyidina Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with him.
He said
we will not that prefer you over what has come to us from that this clarification.
آمنا برب هارون وموسى.
Is that we believe in the Lord of that Moses and Aaron.
ونحن آمنا برب هارون وموسى وعيسى ورب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And that we believe in the Lord of not only Moses and Aaron but also Isa and Muhammad, Jesus and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل يكون السحرة أفضل منكم؟
Is that are the Pharaoh's magicians better than any one of us?
الخير دونكم أمامكم.
Is that we have every opportunity for good in front of us.
فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم.
Is that when they are resolute in their affairs and they are true to Allah, that it would be even better for them.
من وصل في الدنيا إلى عين اليقين فقد دخل الجنة في الدنيا فالله يقول ولمن خاف مقام ربه جنتان.
And so that whoever that reaches the station of the eye of certainty is that the paradise-like state of the afterlife which is brought forth in this world they will enter into it. And Allah Ta'ala says as for the one who fears their Lord is that they will have two paradises. There is a village in Hadramaut called Taris. In it is buried Al-Habib Hassan bin Salih al-Bahr al-Jufri. This Habib used to be in a state of solitude and he'd repeat the name of Allah, Ya Latif, over and over again, thousands upon thousands of times, Ya Latif, he would just keep repeating it.
حتى صفت له ساعة من تجليات اسم لطيف على قلبه فكشف له عن الجنة.
And so that until he recited it so much, is that in one moment, is that his heart became pure such that it received a manifestation of the name of Allah Latif, it was unveiled for him that a vision of paradise. Someone might say, is that how could someone see paradise where they're still here in this dunya?
الصحابة قال أحدهم إني أجد رائحة الجنة من جهة أحد أشم رائحة الجنة.
One of the companions said in the battle of Uhud, is that indeed that I smell the scent of paradise near the mountain Uhud, and he was walking towards it.
ولذلك يسمونها النسمات نسيمات الوصال.
This is what are called نسيمات الوصال. That is that sweet little breezes of that connection.
تأتيك من حضرات القرب.
That comes from the stations of proximity.
لا تشمها الأنوف بل تشمها القلوب.
And these are not smelled with the nose, rather they are smelled and perceived with the heart.
يقول الإمام الحداد هبت نسيمات الوصال من جانب القدس العلي واستغرقت أنوارها عوالم القلب الخلي.
That's very hard to translate. But essentially, the basic meaning of that is that the sweet breezes of being close to Allah have blown through, and that they have penetrated that which is in the heavens and connected the servant to his Lord.
Shalom, sayfamuna biqulubihim. Hum sayfamuna biqulubihim.
He said, "Don't worry, you're going to understand with your hearts what that means."
لذلك نحن نقول أنتم احضروا قلوبكم في هذا الدرس.
And he said, this is why that I'm telling you to that come to this gathering, to this class with your hearts.
لأن المعنى أكبر من المبنى.
Because the meaning is much greater than that the outward dimension.
اسم سيدنا محمد ليس ذاتا لسيدنا محمد.
Is it the name of سيدنا محمد is not the essence of سيدنا محمد.
فالحقيقة المحمدية أعظم.
Is that the reality of the true Muhammadan nature is that even greater?
Allah, Allah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
So it was unveiled for him something of the bliss of paradise. So he said that I do not want that any of the maidens of paradise. I don't know any of the pleasure of paradise. I want the veil to be lifted, meaning he wanted Allah.
أنا أريدك أنت يا ربي. أنت مقصودي إلهي أنت مقصودي ورباك مطلوبي.
Is it? In other words, he was saying, Allah, it is you that I want. Is it? It is you that I seek. As Imam Haddad says in one of his poems, O Allah, you are the one that I seek, and it is your contentment that I want.
ولذلك سيأتي لنا في أحد السمات هنا مجالسة الله للذاكرين.
And this is why that one of the traits of the people of the science, as will come, is that they remember Allah.
هو لمن جلس لم يجلس إلا ليذكر الله.
And it is specifically for the one who sits down, and the only reason to sit down is to remember Allah.
الله يوفقنا وإياكم إن شاء الله تعالى. الكلام يطول والوقت يذهب.
He says that there's a lot to be said and that time goes quickly.
ثم قرأتم.
نعم نقرأ عن الصوفية. So this is a subchapter on the Sufi. Whoever reaches the fruits of having excellence in action and takes on the qualities pursuant with Allah's address and of His Messenger, the Chosen One, both experientially with realization, then he is a Sufi. One is not called a Sufi except that they have reached the station of the Eye of Certainty. The Messenger of Allah said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, spiritual excellence, ihsan, is to worship Allah as though you see him, and if you do not see him, then he sees you. As for those who are loyal to them and struggle to follow their way, but have not attained the station of the Eye of Certainty, then that person is that. He translates it here as Sufi-like, mutasawwuf, but not a Sufi. And then he says, whoever is loyal to them, but has not completed their struggle to follow their path, then this person attempts to resemble them. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever tries to resemble people, then he is of them. Imam Abdullah bin Abi Bakr al-Durr says in his book, Al-Kibrit al-Ahmar, the Red Sulfur, the Sufi is the one who is the traveler on the path and he has arrived. The Mutashabbih is the one resembling them, is he is the one who holds on to the path and loves them. The Mutashabbih, the Mutashabbih is the one resembling those who resemble them, and he is the one who believes in their path and loves them. And whoever loves a people is of them. And in the authenticated hadith, a person is with the one he loves.
Allahumma fi'na thalik, inshaAllah. Al-arkanu al-din thalatha. Al-islam huwa ilmu al-shari'a. Wa iman ilmu al-tariqa. Wa ihsan ilmu al-hariqa.
So Islam has three pillars. Is that we have iman, which is about belief. Is that we have that Islam, which is that about practice. And then we have ihsan, which is about treading the path.
فَلِذَلِكَ الْمَطْلُوبُ مِنَّا فِي هَذِي الدُّنْيَا أَن نَحْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّنَا نَرَاهُ.
This is why we are called to, while we're here in this world, to worship Allah as if we see Him.
تَسْتَشْعُرُ قُرْبَهُ.
Is that we bring to heart that He is close to us.
تَسْتَشْعُرُ وُجُودَهُ.
We bring to heart His existence.
تَشْعُرُ بِهِ.
Is that we know that He exists.
هُوَ خَلَقَكَ لَهُ.
He created us for Him.
وَخَلَقَ الْكَوْنَ كُلَّهُ لَكَ.
And created everything that is in existence for us.
سَخَّرَهُ لَكَ.
And subjugated it to us.
هُوَ لَا يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى سَمَاوَاتُ وَلَا أَرْضُ وَلَا عَرْشُ وَلَا غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ.
He does not need the heavens nor the earth or the throne or anything else.
وَلَا نُجُومُ وَلَا أَقْمَارُ وَلَا شُمُوسُ.
And that He does not need the stars and the suns and the moons.
سَخَّرَهَا كُلَّهَا لَكَ.
He said He subjugated all of this to us.
لِكَيْ تَحْظَى بِسَاعَةِ صَفَاءٍ مَعَ رَبِّكَ.
So that we could have a sa'at al-safa, a moment of purity with our Lord.
وَلِذَلِكَ جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ سَكَنًا.
This is why He made that a night, a time of rest.
هُدُوء.
That stillness.
حَتَّى تَنَسَ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ.
So that we can find intimacy in the remembrance of Allah.
وَيَعْلَمْ أَنَّكَ تُحِبُّهُ.
And so that He can know that we love Him.
فَلِذَلِكَ قُلْنَا بِالْأَمْسِ.
And this is why we said yesterday,
أن تطلب رضوان الله.
Is that we should seek the contentment of Allah.
ورضوان الله.
The contentment of Allah.
إذا رأى إذا لم ير في قلبك إلا الله ورسوله.
Is when you only see in your heart that Allah and His Messenger.
صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم وفقنا لذلك. يقول.
Allah Ta'ala gives tawfiq.
السالك الواصل. سلك الطريق. سلق التوجيهات النبوية استمر لم يتغير لا في صغره ولا كبره لا في حربه ولا سلمه لا في غناه ولا في فقره لا في إقبال الناس ولا إقبالهم هذه يسمونه الثبات حتى يصل.
He said the true Sufi is the one who has treaded the path and has arrived. And he is the one who is consistent throughout his life despite all these different states, in times of difficulty, in times of ease, whether people accept him or whether people reject him, whether he is poor or whether he is wealthy, is that they've been sincere to the Lord and continuously tread this path in such that they've arrived. He was not deceived by this world or by wealth or by status because he doesn't incline towards them at all.
يقصد الله.
He only seeks Allah.
حتى يصل إليه.
Until he arrives unto him.
قال الله عن سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Allah said about Sayyidina Muhammad.
في رحلته الإسراء والمعراج.
And on the night of الإسراء والمعراج.
ما زاغ البصر وما طغى.
Is that his eyes did not divert nor did it transgress.
زاغ أي مجرد التفاتة العين لم يلتفت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما سوى الله ولم يطلب لم يزد على ذلك.
And so that زاغ means to not even that turn, so that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's eyes didn't turn, that nor did they transgress.
ماذا بعدها لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى.
Allah says after that, he indeed saw the greatest signs of his Lord.
فإن استطعت أن تحفظ عين قلبك أن لا يكون لك رجاء إلا أن يرضى عنك ربك ولا هم إلا أن يرضى عنك ربك ولا تفكير إلا أن يرضى عنك ربك عند ذلك سترى آياته الكبرى.
And so that if you can preserve that at the level of your heart, is that there is nothing more important to you, your only concern, your only thought is to that have your heart in a state such that Allah Ta'ala will be content with you, this will lead to you seeing the greatest signs of your Lord.
عش حياتك.
Live your life.
اعمل.
And work.
سافر.
Travel.
تزوج.
Marry.
البس.
Wear.
لكن اجعل كل ذلك من أجل أن تصل به إلى رضوان الله.
But make all of that a means for you to arrive to the contentment of Allah.
عش حياتك.
Live your life
مع الله.
With Allah.
عش حياتك.
Live your life
لله.
For the sake of Allah.
عش حياتك.
Live your life
حتى تلقى الله.
Until you meet Allah.
فيكون هو.
So that he will be
عشت من أجله.
That you live for his sake.
ومت لأجله.
And you died for his sake.
عند ذلك.
And when this happens,
يحكم عليك بالحياة الأبدية.
Is that he will grant you everlasting life.
قال سيدي حبيب علي الحبشي تلك العطية إن شاء الله تكون سهلة تلك العطية إن حلت على رجل أحيته حقا ولو قد صار في التراب.
He said this gift is that when it's granted to someone it will bring them to life even if previously they were like dust.
السالك الصوفي هو لا يتأثر بالفتن.
So the Sufi is the one who's traveled the path and arrived, is that he is not impacted by tribulations.
قال سبحانه وتعالى من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عهد الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا.
Allah Ta'ala says, and from amongst the believers, there are those that have been truthful to their Lord, been truthful to the covenant that they've taken their Lord. And then from among them are those that that died for his sake, and then there are those who are waiting, and those who are waiting that they haven't changed anything at all.
والمتشبه هو الذي بدأ يسلك الطريق إلا أنه لم يصل.
Is that the one resembling them is the one who has started to tread the path, but he has yet to arrive.
لكنه محب لهم.
But he loves them also.
موال لهم.
And is loyal to them.
هذا يرجى أن يكون منهم.
And the hope is that this person will be from among them.
ومتشبه المتشبه.
And the one resembling those who resemble them.
هو الذي لم تسمع له الفرصة.
Is the one who has not had the opportunity to travel their path.
سمع عن الإمام الغزالي مثلا إلا أنه لم يجالسه.
Is that he heard about the likes of the great Imam al-Ghazali from those that he sat with.
سمع مثلا عن تريم إنه لم يستطع أن يسافر إلى تريم.
He's heard of a sacred city like Tarim even though he's not been able to travel there.
لكنه يحبه.
But he loves it.
يتمنى لحظة أن يكون معهم.
And that wishes for just with one moment to be with those people.
يتمنى لحظة أن يسر الله له اجتماع بهم.
And that he wishes for even a moment that Allah would allow them to meet with them.
وشوقاه إلى أحبابه.
And that he said things like that, oh how I long to be with those whom I love.
هذا هو أملنا الوحيد.
And that this is our only hope.
المحبة.
Love.
هي رأس مالنا.
Is that this is our capital.
أعمالنا قليلة.
Is that that acts are tainted.
أعمالنا قصيرة.
Is that our lifespans are short.
الفتن تحيط بنا من كل جانب.
And that we are completely surrounded by tribulations.
تمسكوا بالحب.
So that hold firmly to love.
لا تفرطوا فيه.
That do not that neglect it.
غذوه أبناءكم وبناتكم.
And that inculcate it in your children.
لا أقل أن يأتي أحدنا الموت وهو محب لهم.
At very least, none of us should die except that we love these people.
اللهم ارزقنا حبك.
May Allah ta'ala bless with the love
of Him. حب نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the love of your Prophet.
اجعلوا هذا الدعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا رزق. أن الواحد يصبح صباح يرزق الله حبه.
Is that we that make this blessed prayer of our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And a person like this in the morning is concerned about this provision of love.
يا سلام. أحسن أرزاق أن الله رزقك حبه.
Is that the greatest of all provision is to be provided the love and the heart for your Lord.
المقصود حبه أي يرز أن الله يحبك.
And that what is that meant here by his love is actually the love of Allah for his servant.
That كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اللهم ارزقني حبك وحب من يحبك.
This is why the Prophet used to say, oh Allah, grant me your love and the love of those whom you love.
وحب نبيك معه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the love of your Prophet, even though he was the Prophet.
نتعلم منه ذلك.
We learn from him how to do this.
اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك.
And the love of every act that will bring us close to your love.
كل يوم الناس يطلبون رزق مال وسيارة وبيت. أنت تطلب هذا يا رب حبك 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 حبك.
Is that every day that there are people that are seeking all different types of provision, that different types of wealth, a house, a car, but this should be what we, the type of provision we are really seeking. Every day we repeat this.
لذلك الصحابة كانوا أغنياء قبل أن يسلموا.
Is it now?
كان أغنياء.
There were some of the companions that were wealthy before they became Muslim.
فلما ذاقوا الحب.
But when they tasted and experience love.
لم يبالوا بما فاتهم من الدنيا.
They did not care that what they didn't have from about what they didn't have from the world.
بل كلما ما فاتهم من الدنيا زادت جرعة المحبة في قلوبهم.
As that everything that they didn't have from the world only increased them in the love that they had in their heart.
صهيب الرومي رضي الله عنه.
That the great companion Suhaib.
ليس بعربي ولا قرشي.
That he wasn't Arab or Quraishi.
بل بلاد الروم كبلادكم.
Is that he Roman. Was Roman.
أتى من بلاد الروم إلى مكة المكرمة.
Is that he came from that the after having lived in Rome to Mecca.
ترك العزة والنعمة إلى أرض غير ذي زرع.
Is that he left then all of the things that he was doing there, the honor and everything that they had there to come there.
سمع عن سيدنا محمد.
And he heard about our Prophet Muhammad.
هاجر إلى الله ورسوله.
And that he's the one who migrated to Allah and his messenger.
لم يبالي بمخاطر الطريق.
That he didn't matter that all of the risks he had to take to get there.
ولم يفكر في موت ولا في حياة.
He wasn't thinking about life or death.
يريد أن يرى وجه النبي محمد.
He wanted to only see the face of the Prophet.
التقى به وأسلم على يديه.
As that he met him and then became Muslim on his hands.
وظل في مكة يتاجر بالمال حتى صار غنيا.
And that he remained in Mecca and that started to do commerce until he became wealthy.
حتى جاء وقت الهجرة.
And when it came time for him to migrate.
فأعد عدته ليخرج مع الجمع للهجرة.
And so he prepared himself and did everything he did, all the necessary preparations to migrate with the others.
فوصل الخبر إلى أبي جهل.
And then Abu Jahl realized is that he was going to migrate.
فجاء إليه.
So he came to him.
قال له إلى أين يا ابن الرومية؟
He says, where are you going?
قال أرحب برسول الله محمد.
That I'm going to then migrate with the Prophet.
قال جئتنا صعلوكا وتخرج صعلوكا يعني لا مال لك.
He says that you will come as a صعلوك يعني a poor, the unimportant person. You're going to leave like that as well.
قال بل أترك لكم كل مالي.
He said, rather, it doesn't bother me, I will leave all of my wealth here with you.
وَلَوْ كَانَ عِنْدِ الْمَزِيدِ لَدَفَعْتُهُ لَكُمْ.
And were I to even have more, then I would also give you that.
قَالُوا يَشْتَرِي هِجْرَةً مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ بِمَالِهِ كُلِّهِ.
So in other words, that he bought his hijrah there with all of his wealth.
حَتَّى وَصَلَ إِلَى قُبَى.
Until he reached the city of Quba.
فَاسْتَقْبَلُوا سَيِّدْنَا عُمَرُ.
And Sayyidina Umar received him
وعانقه.
And hugged him.
قال رسول الله ينتظرك.
and said that the Messenger of Allah is waiting for you. He said, the Messenger of Allah is waiting for me. He didn't expect this.
فإذا برسول الله قام له.
And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stood up for him.
وأنتم تعلم أن رسول الله لا يقوم إلا لفاطمة رضي الله عنها.
That our Prophet, we know, really only stood for Sayyidah Fatima.
قال ربح البيع أبا يحيى.
And he said, is that your transaction has been profitable, O father of Yahya?
أي بيع هو خسر الدنيا.
Is that what transaction is he referring to here? He lost everything from the world.
في ميزان أهل الدنيا.
Is that in relation to the scales of the people of dunya?
ربح الله ورسوله.
That really profited that closeness to Allah and His Messenger.
يا صهيب لقد أنزل الله فيك قرآنا ومن الناس من يشري نفسه ابتغاء مرضات الله والله رؤوف بالعباد.
And Allah Ta'ala revealed a verse about him there among people, that there are among people that buy that paradise by
ومن الناس من يشري نفسه ابتغاء مرضات الله.
And that there are those that sell their own self and everything that they have seeking the contentment of Allah.
والله رؤوف بالعباد.
And that Allah is indeed compassionate with His servants.
نحن لا نقول لكم اتركوا أموالكم ولا بيوتكم.
I'm not telling you to get rid of all of your wealth and your homes.
لكن نقول اتركوا في قلوبكم ما لا يحب الله أن يراه في قلوبكم.
And that I'm rather saying to you is that remove from your hearts what Allah Ta'ala doesn't want there to be in, therein.
هل أنتم مستعدون؟
He says that inshallah we are ready for this.
Inshallah. هو ناظر في قلوبنا وإياه.
He is the one who gazes upon our hearts.
حقيقة.
In reality.
ألا يلا بذرة من محبة الله أفنى بها عن كل ما سوى الله.
Oh Allah, we ask you for the smallest bit of your love, through which that we become annihilated from everything that is in existence.
Al-Shaykhun al-Habib Bakr al-Mashhur, radiallahu anhum.
One of our teachers, Habib Bakr al-Mashhur,
قال ما معنى كلامه أن في آخر الزمان يكثر المدد ويقل الطالبون.
Is that in the end of time, is that there will be a lot of madad, spiritual support, but there will be very few people who seek it.
فإذا كنت أنت من القلة أعطاك الله مددا على قدر المعرضين.
So he says, if you're from those who are seeking it, Allah Ta'ala will give you that madad, that He will give you that madad to the extent of all of those that are turning away from it.
مثلا لو أن كل ليلة هناك مليون نظرة من الله عز وجل.
So let's say, for instance, that every day there's a million gazes from Allah.
ينظر الله بها على بلدة سكانها مليون اثنين مليون.
Is that Allah Ta'ala gazes upon a particular place that has 1 million or 2 million people that live there.
لم يرى فيها مؤمنا أو مصليا أو قائما بالليل إلا واحد أعطاه الله مليون نظرة.
And that if there's only one person who's standing at prayer night exposing himself to that these gazes, is that all of those gazes that person will get.
عندنا مثل في حضرموت يقولون من نام كلوا عشاء.
There's a proverb in Hadramaut that says whoever falls asleep will lose the opportunity to eat their dinner.
ما حد بيصحيك.
Is that no one's going to wake you up to eat your dinner.
الله يكرمنا وياكم إن شاء الله تعالى.
الله
بوقتنا. كم تحب نستمر؟ أنت بتبدأ هنا. نستمر ونقف. كما تحب as you like. شو كيف هما ترتيبهم؟
ممكن نفتح المجال للأسئلة.
أسئلة طيب.
نعم طيب. So if there's any questions that we can have about 10 minutes of questions inshallah. I'm sorry, I can't hear you. Oh, yeah, Habib Hassan bin Saleh al-Bahr al-Jafri was his name.
What's the significance of the name as opposed to one of the other?
في قال تسأل ان ذكرتم القصة.
نعم.
الحبيب حسن صالح الذي كان يكثر من اسمه اللطيف سبحانه وتعالى وما هي خاصية الاسم الله اللطيف
تسأل عن خاصية اسم الله اللطيف
نعم
هذا من
فوائد يعني تكراره نعم.
أحيانا يسمون اسم الله الحسنى ما يتوقف عليها من النفعان هي أسرار من علم لدني بمعنى يلهم الله عز وجل أصحابها من إذا أكثر من الذكر كشف الله له عن سر هذا الاسم فهو من أعلوم التي لا تباح أسرارها إلا من أذن له طبعا
He is saying that there's no doubt every name of Allah has a special property about it. And he said that this knowledge is a knowledge that is from is a type of knowledge called the ilm al-dunni. That is a knowledge that comes directly from the divine presence. And this is a knowledge that is usually kept secret and only that revealed to the hearts and unveiled to the hearts of the righteous.
ولكن نعطيها يعني لمحة من أسرار هذا الاسم لمحة.
He says, I'm just going to literally a glance, just a little bit. I will give you about this name.
من أسرار أو لمحات اسم الله اللطيف أن من أكثر من هذا الاسم فإن الله عز وجل إذا لم يرفع عنه البلاء خففه عليه فصار لطفا خفيا به.
One of the special properties of this name is that if we recite it often, is that Allah might completely remove tribulation from someone, and if He doesn't remove tribulation completely, He will lighten the burden of that tribulation. And that person, that if they go through tribulation, it will be made easy for them. And this is why Shaykh Abu Bakr bin Salim addressed Allah by saying, Ya Khafi al-Lutf, O subtly benevolent one, O subtle in his benevolence. Because is that oftentimes this benevolence comes to us from our Lord in subtle ways where we don't even perceive.
Ya Khafi al-Lutf, Ya Latif al-Sum'a.
Ya Khafi al-Lutf, O subtle in benevolence. And Ya Latif al-Sunnah, oh, that benevolent in creation.
لماذا يا خفي اللطف؟ لأنه أكثر الناس ينسبون نجاحهم إلى أنفسهم ولم يعلموا لولا لطف الله لما نجحوا ولما نجوا.
And so why do we say, oh, subtle and benevolent? Because the vast majority of us attribute our own success to our own selves. When the reality is that it's really from Allah.
Next.
Amma.
Sayyid al-Habib.
نحن نسألك.
لا لا أسألك. عندي سؤال وطلب.
يا الله الله يستر.
سؤال. هذا الذي تأتيه مليون نظرة إلى الله أكرمه بذلك. هل يعني
يتحمل.
ممكن يعطي غيره من هذه النظرات؟ كان هذا
أكبر تعطيلة أيوة أنا سؤال جيد أنا كذلك يعني
دوري هذا يسأل للحبيب عمر ما شاء الله لكن إن حصل لك هذا فلا تبخل علينا إن شاء الله إن أذن الله لنا فكما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه وهذا عند أولياء الله النظرات موجودة عند أولياء الله فإذا أحببتكم السمع الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به جزاك الله خير وإن شاء الله أنت منه إن شاء الله آمين إن شاء الله آمين شو
So he's asking he was asking about what Habib was saying about receiving the gazes is that if someone that receives those gazes those million gazes is that can they then also be a conduit for other people to receive those gazes So they receive them and then they give them out. And then he was saying to Habib is that when he receives the gazes too, you know, basically pass them to us too. And then Habib was trying to be humble and put it on Amul Tarif, which let's just put it, all of us on both of them, is that all of the gazes that they both receive, that inshallah, is that they'll share with us as well, bidnillahi ta'ala.
قال سيدنا فخر الوجود نحن الكرام فمن أتانا قاصدا نال السعادة عندما يلقانا.
Shaykh Abubakar bin Salman said, we are kiram, we are noble people. Anyone that comes to us with strong intention is that they will attain felicity when they meet us.
هذا كذا واحد من جاء إلى السيد في عمر وقال يا حبيبي نحن مجينا وغير نظرات وغير هكذا فقال نحن الكرام فمن أتانا قاصدا نال السعادة عندما يلقانا فالله يجعلنا منهم شرفا.
So one time someone came to Habib Umar and they said, Habib, that we want gazes, we want you to gaze upon us. And then Habib recited this line of poetry of Shaykh Abubakar Salman. He said, we are that noble people, and whoever comes to us with strong intention, is that they will attain felicity when they meet us.
النظرة هذه موجودة حتى عند أبيك وأمك إذا كانوا مسلمين طبعا.
The gazes that come from even our parents, يعني, of course, being they're Muslim.
وتعتقد كل مسلم كل مؤمن ولي الله.
And that every believer has a dimension of wilaya, of protection from Allah.
الله يكرمنا إن شاء الله وإياكم.
كان واحد من السلف من الصالحين وقف على صعيد عرفة. One of the righteous was standing on the plain of Arafah.
وصاح بأعلى صوته.
And that he called out loud.
فالتفت الناس الحجاج كلهم إليه خير إيش فيك ماذا بك؟
And that many of the hujjaj around him looked at him like, what's going on? Are you okay?
فقال أنتم ضيوف الله وأولياءه فأحببت أن تنظروا إلي.
He says that you are the guests of Allah and that His awliya, so I wanted you all to look at me.
هذا مجذوب حاج مذجوب مجذوب حياكم الله. سؤال آخر.
We'll just take one more question.
In relation to the verse that was first mentioned in the beginning.
في مايك.
In relation to the verse that was mentioned in the beginning about sincerity, can a person ever consider themselves in this dunya being sincere? And does that then change in the akhirah for that person, since that question is being asked?
So in other words, so I understand, as long as we're here in this world, can we ever know that we're sincere? Whereas in the akhirah we're going to testify to it, but how in the world can we ever know?
وقال بالنسبة الآية ذكرتم ليسأل الصادقين عن صدقهم ويقول هل يمكن إنسان ليسأل الصادقين عن صدقهم ممكن إنسان في الدنيا يعني بأنه صادق يعني وهل يعني هناك يعني
يكون هو صادق في الدنيا
يعني هل هو يرى صدقه أو ممكن يظن أنه صادق أو في الدنيا ما يرى هذا أبدا وهو بس عبارة عن إخبار في الآخرة ف هل هناك فرق يعني في الدنيا والآخرة في هذه المسألة؟
ما فهمت سؤالكم.
يعني هل هناك علامة على أن الإنسان ممكن يعلم أنه صادق في الدنيا؟ ممكن أقول هكذا.
هناك علامة أنا عملي صادق ولكن الصادق الحقيقي يرى نفسه أنه ليس صادق.
So there is
يعني
a sign.
يتهم نفسه يعني.
There is a sign that we can know whether or not we're sincere when we're here in this world, but the truly sincere and truthful one will never see himself as being sincere and truthful. He'll always let take himself to account and put himself into question.
لكن علامة الصادق في الدنيا هو أنه يثبت في جميع الأحوال بمعنى الناس مدحوه أو ذموه إيش اسمه في حالتي يعني صحتي ومرضي في حالتي صغاري وكباري لا يتغير لا يتبدل ثابت 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 هذا هو صادق مع الله.
The sign of the sincere person in this world is that they are firm in their deen in all of their different states. When they're young, when they're old, when they're sick, when they're healthy, whether people praise them or turn away from them, is that they are firm in all of their different states.
وما بدلت الدين.
And he then quoted the verse is that they change nothing.
Allah يجعلنا إياكم منهم.
Allah Ta'ala make us all from them.
اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين.
And oh, you who believe that have taqwa of Allah and be with the sincere.
Alhamdulillah. كان مشايخنا أن يعطيكم فائدة أحيانا واحد يقول أنا لم أجد علماء أجالسهم أنا في بلد بعيدة أنا في أمريكا أنا كذا قال مشايخنا إذا قرأت كتب الإمام الغزالي مثلا الإمام حداد فنوي أن تجالسه فأنت بذلك تأخذ لأنه عندما يقول لك يقول اعلم يا أخي رحمني الله وياك فهو يخاطبك فهذه أي مجالسة إن شاء الله.
So he's given us a really, really big benefit here. He says this is a fa'ida benefit that he took from his teachers. Because someone might say, okay, you just said that I need to be with the righteous people, I need to be with the truthful people, I live in a far off place, that my life is as it is, I'm not able to sit with these people, so what do I do? He said, is it read the books of Imam al-Ghazali and Imam al-Haddad with the intention of being with them, sitting with them, being in their company. And that you find that in their books is that they will say things like, oh brother of mine, speaking in the second person, so they're speaking to you. So make that intention, and it will take the same place of having actually have been in their presence.
وقالوا فإذا قرأت الإمام حداد يقول لك اعلم يا أخي رحم الله إياكم فقل آمين لأنه يدعو لك.
So that when Imam Haddad says like that, oh no, oh brother, that may Allah for have mercy upon me and you, that you're supposed to say Ameen because he's you're one of the people he's intending.
اقرأ كتبهم ولو لم تفهمها.
He said, read their books even if you do not understand them.
يعني تقصد نقصد قراءة كتبهم بالتبرك لكن العمل لابد من شرح طبعا.
And that we read their books with the intention of seeking the blessing of them and we strive to put them into practice.
الحمد لله.
خلاص النظرات تقسمها علينا ان شاء الله
البنك
النظرات للطلبه
النظرات الله ينظر الينا وليكم ان شاء الله تعالى الفاتحه ان الله يملي قلوبنا اياكم نظرات منه ولحظات منه ونسمات منه اللهم هؤلاء قد حضروا وتركوا بيوتهم وتركوا منازلهم وتركوا اهاليهم وتركوا راحاتهم وتركوا شهواتهم وجاءوا يقصدون نظرة من نظراتك وساعة من ساعاتك ولحظة من لحظاتك وأنت الكريم وأنت العظيم وأنت المعطي وأنت الودود وأنت القريب فمن يجود إن لم تجد أنت من يعطي إن لم تعطي أنت من يغفر إن لم تغفر أنت من يرحم إن لم ترحم أنت من يتكرم إن لم تتكرم أنت أنت أهل التقوى وأنت أهل المغفرة فنسألك اللهم إلا ما نظرت إلى ضعفنا وإلى عجزنا نعم نحن لا نستحق تلك النظرات نعم نحن لا نستحق أن نجتمع أن نذكرك نعم نحن نستحق لأننا عصيناك في الظاهر والباطن في السر والجهر ولكنك كرمك سترنا حتى صار سترك جميلا صار سترك أجمل من أعمالنا سترك أجمل من أحوالنا سترك أجمل من صلاتنا فما أعظمك وما أحسنك وما أكرمك اللهم هؤلاء إخواننا وأخواتنا نسألك اللهم أن تكرمنا وإياهم بنظرة في هذه الليلة أو في هذه الساعة أو في هذه اللحظة اللهم نظرة من نظراتك نظرة تزيل عنا وتن المنى منا وكل الهنا نعطاه في كل حين ألا هي الله بنظرة من العين الرحيمة تداوي ما بنا من أمراض سقيمة اللهم اجعلها نظرات لا تنقطع ورحمات لا تنقطع وأنوار لا تنقطع ومدد لا ينقطع ورحمة لا تنقطع وجود لا ينقطع ومحبة لا تنقطع وسر لا ينقطع وإنعام لا ينقطع وإفضال لا ينقطع في خير وطف عافية حتى نلقى الأحبة محمدا وصحبه حتى نلقى الأحبة محمدا وآله حتى نلقى الأحبة محمدا وصحبه صلى الله عليه وسلم ونلقى أحبتنا ومشايخنا من أهل السلوك وأهل التصوف أهل لا إله إلا الله أهل علم اليقين وعين اليقين وحق اليقين اللهم إننا لم نكن إن لم نكن منهم ولم نكن معهم ولم نكن فيهم إلا أننا نسألك أن ترزقنا محبتهم وأن ترزقنا التعلق بهم اللهم كما جعلتهم في قلوبنا فاجعلنا في قلوبهم اللهم كما رزقتنا محبتهم فارزقهم محبتنا في قلوبهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أرحم الراحمين اجعل الذنوب مغفورة والعيوب مستورة والحاجات مقضية يا كريم يا كريم يا كريم لولا فضلك ولولا جودك ولولا إحسانك لما دعوناك ولما رجوناك يا أكرم الأكرمين يا ربي أنت نصيري فلقني فلقنا كل خير واجعل جنانك مصيرنا واختم بالإيمان الأجال وصل في كل حالة على مزيل الضلالة من كلمته الغزالة محمد الهادي الدال والحمد لله شكرا على نعم منه تترى نحمده سرا وجهرا وبالغدايا والأصال واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. نمكنكم كما لقانا شيء سيفنا حجاب قال بن حبيب السقاف هذا الذكر بالسند المتصل حي يحمل وشو حدا شيء يحيى المرة.
So he's going to لتلقين بذكر that he took from that his sheikh Habib Abdul Qadir al-Saqqaf. So he's going to recite it and we recite it after him.
لا إله إلا الله
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 محمد رسول الله
محمد رسول الله
صلى الله عليه وعلى آله صحبه وسلم
وصحبه وسلم
حق علي أن نحيا وعلي أن نموت وعلي أن نبعث إن شاء الله من أمن الذين خافوا عليهم ولهم يحزنون. اللهم كما جمعتنا في هذه الدنيا فاجمعنا في برازخ النور مع أهل النور واجمعنا مع الحضور واجمعنا بسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في أعلى فراتيس الجنان ولا تخلف أحدا منا ولا من أهلنا ولا أولادنا ولا أباء وأمهاتنا. اللهم كان لنا حاضرين من كان له أب أو كانت له أم أو أخت أو زوجة أو ابن أو عم أو خال لم يكرم بالإسلام فنسألك اللهم نظرة من نظراتك ولحظة من لحظاتك أن تحرك في قلبي لواعج الهداية ولواعج المحبة ولواعج النور حتى يهتدي حتى يهتدي حتى يهتدي إن هو إلا عبد أنعمنا عليه فأنعم علينا وعليهم بالثبات على لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم متحققين بحقائقها حسا مع نظاه باطنا وما نوى مشايخنا وإلى حضرة النبي.
اللهم صل على محمد.